This video describes the content of what would have been the first computer lab. You will get to practice these steps during the applied part of the course. In the following slides, I will present the preprocessing of iPro to sequencing data, with a focus on RNA-seq. Take a look at lecture number 8, slides 28, to contrast it with ChIP-seq data preprocessing. By the end of this lecture, you should be able to describe the HTS data preprocessing steps. But let's start at the beginning and with a question. What actually comes out of a sequencer? Commonly, a compressed text file in the FASTQ format. Take the time to look up the Wikipedia page on the FASTQ format for more details. Briefly, it stands for FASTQ Day with Quality. A FASTQ text file contains the base pair sequence of every fragment that was sequenced by the machine. These sequences are called colloquially reads. In a FASTQ file, a read information is reported over four lines. The first line contains the read identifier. The second line its nucleotide sequence. The first line is historical and has no content but a plus sign. The fourth line contains the quality as reported by the sequencer for every base pair of a sequence. The quality is the measure of how confident the sequencer is that it called the right base. The quality is a number ranging from 0, bad, to 40, best, on an inverse logarithmic scale. To have a single quality value associated with every base, required to encode the values 0 to 40 into unique characters. For example, the exclamation mark corresponds to a value of 0 and the capital letter I to the value of 40. The FASTQ file delivered to us by the sequencing facility is the raw data. Before we can use that data in our research, we need to make sure that it is of a quality good enough. If we observe technical artifacts, we need to take action to remove these. When we manipulate the data to remove artifacts, we need to be cautious and ensure that we do not bias the data. Hence, for every step where the data is manipulated, we need to reassess its quality. This process is called the preprocessing. In the figure, you can see the flow for the RNA-seq data preprocessing. It consists of a number of rounds of data cleaning, namely ribosomal RNA filtering, and quality-based trimming and adapter removal, each flanked by quality assessment steps. The final results are so-called clean reads that will be used for processing. We will, in the next slides, focus on these cleaning and QA steps. The initial step is a quality assessment of the raw data. A commonly used tool is FastQC. FastQC is run on a FastQ file or a set of files and generates an HTML report. This report has numerous aspects, which details can be found on the tool's webpage. Three of these are of particular relevance for us, and I will describe them in the next slides. The examples shown are from a real dataset we worked with. This is the first plot of interest. It represents the quality score distribution across all bases. Remember that Illumina uses a sequencing by synthesis approach and that every read has the same length. The x-axis represents the position in the read. Note that the first 9 bases are individual, whereas the rest is binned into a group of 5 bases. The read length in that example is 101 base pair. So the last bin only represents 2 bases. The y-axis represents a quality score ranging from 0, bad, to 40, best. For every base pair bin on the x-axis, there is a box plot in yellow describing the distribution of the quality values. The black thin line are the whiskers. The yellow box represents 50% of the data between the lower and upper quartile. The red bar is the median and the blue line is the mean. Looking at this plot, it is obvious that the quality degrades with time, implying that we should take corrective measures and trim the end of the reads whenever the quality is lower than the threshold we set. This is, in my opinion, the overmost relevant plot for RNA-seq data preprocessing. It shows on the x-axis the average GC content and on the y-axis the number of reads. The read line is the density distribution of the GC content in the sample. A density plot is like an histogram where the bins would be infinitesimally small and you would draw a line linking the top of the histogram bars. In other words, 100% of the data is below the curve. In this example, most of the data lies in between 26 and 65% GC. There is an extra shoulder from 65 to 82% GC, and we will come back to that. The blue curve, called theoretical distribution, is a model based on the data. It is a normal distribution modeled after the overall dataset GC content average and variance. It allows for assessing whether the red curve is different from the expected blue curve. Given that we have millions of reads, the authors take the assumption that the GC content should be normally distributed. Think of the lower grade numbers. Here, based on the difference between the blue and red curve, we probably need to take some corrective measures. A third element of importance in the FastQC report is the table of overrepresented sequences. These are sequences that occur more frequently than would be expected by chance. A note here, FastQC was designed for assessing DNA sequencing, where the coverage would be a constant across all sequences. For RNA-seq, the situation is different, as some genes can be so highly expressed that they account literally for millions of reads, and could hence appear overrepresented. Here, this may be the case for the second line. The first line is a sequencing adapter. From these combined results, we know we need to trim the reads using a quality-based cutoff and to remove adapter sequences left over. We also need to investigate what the unknown sequence is. First, to remove adapter sequences and trim the bad quality bases, more about that in the next slide, we use a tool called Trimomatic. After running it, since it modifies the data, we rerun the quality assessment with FastQC. On the right panel above, you can see the effect on the quality. It looks much better now. A side effect of the trimming, as can be seen in the left graph that shows the density distribution of the read length, the x-axis represents the read length and the y-axis the number of reads. Reads are not anymore of unique length. In that example, some have a size between 50 and 99 base pair instead of the initial 101. The quality-based trimming uses a window-based scanning. In this example, a window of 5 base pair, the rectangle, will scan the read. The quality of the read is depicted as a graph under the sequence. The red line represents our selected cutoff. The scanning window will go through the read, and whenever the average quality of the 5 base pair in the window goes below our cutoff threshold, the read will be trimmed at that position. This results in a shorter read with an higher average quality. Back to our example, we have seen that Trimomatic helped correct some of the observed bias. However, it did not affect the putative anomaly observed in the GC distribution. Neither did it remove the unknown sequence. It did, however, succeed in removing the adapters. How should we go about the unknown sequence? Take a minute to think how you would do. I would copy-paste the sequence into the NCBI BLAST webpage. As it were, I just did that. See the next slide. The sequence is an rRNA. Take another minute to think whether we should be surprised by this. Reflect on the amount and types of rRNA in the cell. About 85% of the RNA in a cell is ribosomal RNA. It is therefore unsurprising, despite the RNA-seq protocol depleting it during the sample preparation, that some of it will be left in our samples. If the amount of rRNA would be too important, it would affect the sequencing depth of that sample. Meaning, the proportion of mRNA would be smaller as we are not interested in ribosomal RNA when conducting RNA-seq. To assess the impact of a ribosomal RNA on our sample, we can perform an rRNA filtering. This can be achieved using a tool called SortMeRNA. Again, as this modifies the data, we perform an additional round of QC and check whether the obtained results are as expected. As you can see from the GC percent distribution, it now almost perfectly matches the theoretical distribution. Based on this whole process, it now appears that we have corrected for the bias observed in a meaningful way and have reads that are now clean. We just ran that process on a single sample. If this would have generated 5 reports, FASTQ0, one for Trim-O-Matic, one for FASTQC trimmed, one for SortMeRNA, one for FASTQC filtered. Imagine even a small data set with 2 conditions and 3 replicates. That's already 30 reports to go through. Very tedious. Phil Evels, who worked at SciLife Lab in Stockholm, did not enjoy this and decided to create a tool called MultiQC that collates all the reports together. The tool gives an overview of the sequencing depth and average GC content. It summarizes all the average quality score plot in a single figure, giving an easy-to-interpret overview. And it summarizes the information from over 40 different tools that can be used for data preprocessing. See, for example, the lower panel that shows the results from SortMeRNA. In that example, it becomes obvious that 2 samples stick out as having a very high rRNA proportion of reads. We have now reached the end of the lecture. I thank you for your attention. You should now be able to describe the HTS data preprocessing.